think the way I kind of explain it is that when you're trying to get picked, every kind of shot you face, you're kind of desperate to make a save, and you feel you need to make that save to kind of state your case of why you should be picked. When you kind of become first choice, you don't view every kind of shot as a threat, as something you have to do, and it's more of an opportunity to kind of shine and to enjoy it, really. And I think that's how I frame it. And basically, ever since London, I think that's been my mindset change. It's why I've kind of been able to keep performing relatively consistently. However, I don't take it for granted. Although I kind of have been the first choice, I know Paddy and Bales are both kind of chomping at the bit. They both want to get selected, and they both want to be selected as the first choice as well, like I did in the previous cycle. Going back to the last cycle with me, Barry and Grubbs, we always had a very good, fun relationship, enjoyed training together, and you kind of knew it was that unwritten rule that you were competing for a spot, and I think it's the same again this year and for this cycle, in that we get on really well, we try and encourage each other through training, we try and kind of get the best out of each other, and you try and ignore the kind of selection factor, because at the end of the day, there's nothing I can do to impact on his chances, or he can do to impact on mine. You can only really look after yourself and then see what happens. I don't just rely on kind of internal squad pressure, but I want to be the best in the world. So I'm always comparing myself to the best goalkeepers in the world, the likes of Jan Stockman, Holland, and other great goalkeepers, Cortez in Spain. Basically, wanting to be seen as, by myself and my peers, kind of as more consistent and better than those guys. Always learn from other guys, so when we go to tournaments, I'm looking at what they do, how they maybe approach certain plays and situations, penalty shuffles, what goalkeepers do, penalty corners, and yet I'm always looking at areas that could improve my game. Even if it's just that one percenter, I'm always looking to get stuff from other goalkeepers, but at the end of the day, I want to be George Pinner, the goalkeeper, and not try and mirror or replicate someone else.